spooky out here.
So now we're going to bring into the modern era, because you know what I'm saying? You mentioned that Fabulous versus Jason. Jason for Freddy versus Jason intro. And they made a whole album dedicated to that.
Like two of them, right?
I don't know if they did too. I know I was aware of the first one, but I wasn't aware of the second one if they made a second one or not. But I remember that shit was hard though, like the beat and everything. And Fabulous. Who you think had the hardest verse though?
You can never make me answer that question, my boy. I can never answer that question.
I'm gonna say it straight up. I think it was Jason. I mean, Jadakiss, because his verse is more like on point in terms of what he's actually spitting. He's Jason.
He's on the subject. I know.
He's more on subject. That's the word for it. He's more on subject.
They're my top five. I can't never put them no other way.
Same, bro. Same. I've always been a fan of Fabulous and Jadakiss, bro. You know, since day one.
Yeah, I remember this. This is crazy.
Yeah, this
is just the intro, though. I think the whole album was called Freddy vs. Jason.
Yeah, the whole album is called Freddy vs. Jason.
They killed this.
Yeah. I was a little late on this one, though. Like, people, I probably found out like a year after it for some reason. But once I found this shit, I was bumping the fuck out of this song, man.
Yeah, it's going crazy.
This one has some production value to it, too, man. They got some nods to the.
I expect them to.
Like, I like that they have nods to the original movies in here and everything. Like, Freddy coming through the wall, that's like classic, you know, Nightmare on Elm Street shit. By the lake, and he's holding something. But you know, Fabulous, he's slick with his rhymes, though, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I can imagine. I gotta replay this, too.
Yeah. This has become like one of my songs that I like playing, you know, during Halloween and shit right here. This is tough. I like how they sampled the Nightmare on Elm Street beat too, and then they flip it, and then when, you know, Jadakiss comes on, they put on the Friday the 13th. I thought that was hard as fuck.
They be going crazy.
Like a goon.
Them two is great.
Dr. Doom. Yeah, Fabulous always snapping, bro.
For sure. Still to this day, both of them.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, for real though, Jadakiss still killing it, man. Like, it's crazy how good those fools are.
To be at that age and still relevant though, like, they don't talk about, look, them old dudes, you forget, like.
Yeah, for real though. They still look pretty young though, too, bro. Like, they've aged pretty good. And shout outs to D Block, man, the Locks, man. Like, them dudes, like, one of the best groups in hip hop ever.
They used to be called the Warlocks.
Is that what that's from? The Warlocks?
That was their first name, was the Warlocks.
Damn, so they shortened it for Bad Boy?
I think Diddy did.
Yeah, I think, yeah, you're right. I remember hearing about that, yeah. Recently found out. I think it was on a podcast or something.
Yeah, that'd be hard, though, the Warlocks.
I think a lot of them dudes originally had more harder kind of vibes, like Big Pun and Terror Squad, before they got on with Fat Joe, man. They were on some straight, like, rapping about demonic shit. You know, they were crazy.
Oh yeah,
you know, but Fat Joe told him, you know, Fat Joe told him, like, hey man, we gotta go commercial with this shit too, you know what I mean? So can't be doing all that crazy shit.
It's all you need somebody to get your shit together.
Yeah, sometimes you need somebody to tell you that hey, that's shit cool, but you also need to do this, you know, for the mainstream or whatever. That's like 3-6 Mafia too. When they first came out, man, when they were on the underground, that shit was crazy, dog. They sound like devil worshippers. It was crazy.
They were saying all type of crazy shit.
Yeah, that's when they were like Triple Six Mafia before. Yeah,
I was probably they ain't got no shit called no shit. That would have been crazy if I'd have seen them do some shit like that.
Yeah. Well, I mean though, what's the main guy from there that's still popping, man? He's been putting out some dope ass music videos. You can even say it's hard, you know what I'm saying? Because it's so dope, man.
Yeah, Juicy J.
Yeah, Juicy J is still snapping, bro. Like, I seen some of his more recent videos. He had a Hannibal mask on and shit, you know, just crazy shit.
Yeah.
He must have been the one, kind of like the, I guess you could call the mastermind.
The only one that really rap like that. The other dude was a DJ.
You know, the one that did that, I think he died, and it was my favorite one. What's his name? Dog, he had a crazy ass name. Oh, hold on, man. Let me look this shit up. Because his verses were... He was probably the most lyrical out of 3-6 Mafia back in the day. Fuck, I can't believe I'm blanking out. I'm going to look it up real quick, man. Lord Infamous. That was my boy, man. Lord Infamous. He's the one that got me in 3-6 Mafia when I heard him. Because he was just more lyrical and just the way his style was. It was creepy. Yeah.